Everybody, welcome back. I am finally doing a wet set video after talking about it forever. I feel like a lot of people are really intimidated by wet sets because you see a lot of like wet set fails, I guess. And it's things that aren't really a fail, it's just things that can be fixed with a little bit more work and patience. But since wet sets aren't commonly done anymore, people get frustrated very easily when it doesn't turn out perfectly on the first go. And it's just, there's a lot of like stress and uncertainty and everything around it. And honestly, they are so super simple and they are my preferred way of doing my hair now. This is Freya. Apparently she is helping out today. So I have collarbone-ish length hair. It's actually slightly longer than collarbone. Prior to that, my hair was about 3 or 4 inches longer. You can do a wet set on pretty much any length of hair as long as it is long enough to wrap around the curler that you are using or long enough to get a good pin curl. I don't do pin curls for wet sets that often because I struggle with them. I will freely admit that I have a hard time getting uniformity with my pin curls for the sake of doing wet sets. It's damp. It's at the point where it's almost dry. I took a shower this morning and I've just been letting it air dry ever since. I prefer my hair to be closer to dry than wet when I do wet sets. And that's because I spray my hair with diluted Lotta Body, and so that just adds more moisture to the hair. If you are not familiar with Lotta Body, this is what it looks like. It's a setting lotion. This is the professional concentrated formula. It is concentrated. You need to dilute it down. Lotta Body recommends doing, it says on normal hair, 2 to 3 parts water to 1 part Lotta Body. On tinted hair and bleached hair, 4 to 5 parts water to 1 part Lotta Body. I dilute mine down just a little bit further. Mine is closer to 5 to 6 parts water to 1 part of Lotta Body. And that's because Lotta Body does hold very, very well. I feel like anything more than that for my specific hair type, it's too much hold. And so the curls themselves look kind of crispy and just very there when they're done. So I just have very basic water sprayer from Amazon. You can get them for around $3. Lotta Body is relatively inexpensive as well. You can usually pick it up for between, I think $9 is the least expensive and like $14, $15 is the most expensive. I have had my bottle for about a month now. I set my hair once a week and I still have this much left. So I have my hair combed out, parted how I want my hair to be. And so I'm just gonna go and spritz all over. I don't get too terribly much on my roots because I feel like if you get a lot of product on your roots, it's really going to weigh everything down and it will prevent your curl set from lasting. I typically get 5 to 6 really, really good days of curl sets out of it, and then one kind of, let's maybe throw your hair up in a braid crown kind of a day with it. Like the longest part of doing my hair is the day that I do my wet set, and even that, setting it really doesn't take that long. Now that I've gotten used to it and I have kind of an established pattern that I use. And I'm using the bristle rollers. This is what they look like. You can see the little bristles sticking out of them. These are are about seven eighths of an inch wide. They look like little bottle cleaners to me in there. And then it's covered, like goes inside of like a little spring, and then it's covered with a probably nylon coating. I really like it because since it's harder than a sponge roller, you do get more consistent, more even curls with it. It honestly does a lot of the work for you, and the bristles really help hold your hair in place as you're rolling. So I'm going to section off my bangs as well as possible. I am in the process of growing out Betty bangs. I cut mine for the last time in March, and they were out here. So getting some pretty good growth on them. They're just in that really awkward stage where you can't really do anything with them. And you may have noticed I did not spray my bangs with a lot of body, and that's because I don't really need like a good firm hold in my bangs. So I'm going with the small guy. And I put the roller towards the middle of the hair, bring it all the way down to the end, or as far down to the end as I can, and start rolling under while using my fingertips to kind of hold those short hairs into place before they are rolled up, like this guy here that's sticking up. These are your roller picks that you use. Just slide that in, and voila. You are in place. And so another reason why I really like the bristle rollers is because I feel like they're a very economical way to get into doing wet sets. Okay, and so I just do a rough part, the front of the hair, using the back of my ear as a guideline. Give it a little brush through. I take my sections just a little bit larger. They are more like an inch and a half than an inch. Most people recommend doing an inch. I prefer mine to be a little bit bigger, so that my curls are just a little bit looser for the initial brush out. If you're wanting tighter curls, definitely go with inch to 3/4 of an inch sections. Fighting me there. I do have very slight layers in my hair, especially towards the front. So that is something to be cognizant of when you are doing your rolling. You just really want to make sure that you get those ends tucked in there nicely. That way you get a more uniform curl. You don't, like I mentioned earlier, you don't get the fish hooks. It's that weird little end piece of a hair that faces a different direction from everywhere else.
I don't really use a pattern per se. I just looked at a bunch of different curl setting patterns and figured out, okay, this is roughly how I want mine to go. The left side of my hair that I'm working on now, I want those curls to all be facing downwards. And then on the right side of my part, which I will show you guys in just a moment, I do those angled towards my face because I want them to go in and down. And you really want to try to make sure that you have your hair as smooth as possible on the roller, because there is nothing worse than getting your hair all tangled up in the roller and then trying to take the rollers out. Because since it does have the little bristles in there, it's like your hair is fighting against you when you try to take them out. Like I just did with my clip. So again, going to do a rough part using my ear as a guide. I'm gonna figure out something to do with that bang there. As I was saying, this side gets rolled slightly differently. Instead of holding the roller horizontally, it is angled towards my face as it's rolled down. And then, since I do a deeper part where more of my hair is going towards the left, on this side I only do two rollers. And give this little section just a little quick brush out. Okay, so I'm actually going to speed through the rest of this because if I did this at regular speed for the remainder of my head, we'd be here forever. Yikes.
I'm glad that I decided that I was just gonna like zip through the rest of it because that took me 15 minutes to do the rest of my head. It really, like I said, the actual setting part of it is the longest part of it. On a good day, I can get my whole headset in about 25 minutes. But it's 25 minutes, one day a week. Every other day of the week, I just wake up, I brush my hair, and it's done. So it usually takes minimum 6 hours for my hair to completely dry. You can get a like a stand dryer or a bonnet attachment for your hair dryer to help speed that process along. It might take less amount of time if you have thinner hair, more time if you have thicker hair. I have very fine hair, but a lot of it, and so that's why mine takes, you know, on the longer side of things. And then if you have long, thick hair, it's going to take even longer. I think that's kind of speaks for itself. But this is it. We are done. My cat is trying to wrestle me now. So the next video that I'm going to do, I'm going to show how to brush out your wet set. Spoiler alert, it's just a lot of brushing and patience. I will talk to you guys next time. Y'all have a fantastic day wherever you are, and thanks for watching.